Career changes for baby boomers may involve learning new job skills or starting a new business or getting involved in a nonprofit. Often the transition involves a new focus on the greater good. I recently spoke about career shifts for experienced workers with Marci Alboher of Encore.com, a nonprofit organization that helps people enter second careers. Alboher is the author of the Encore Career Handbook. Marci, good to have you here. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
And you are in Phoenix kind of launching this Encore Career Handbook. You're not from Phoenix. What are you doing here?
I live in New York City. You're right to recognize that. I'm here because I'm leading a very big book tour all around the country talking about Encore Careers. And the reason we chose Phoenix as the launch is that Phoenix is kind of known as like the birthplace of retirement, right? Sun City, all these places, but people went for kind of endless leisure. Well, the trend we're going to be talking about now and what this book is all about is a new kind of thing to do with this life stage. And it's actually taking hold right here in Phoenix with the organization Experience Matters that you know all about. So we just thought it would be fitting to talk about the Encore movement in a place where that's taking hold, in the very same place where retirement got its start.
Indeed. And the concept, the book is Encore Career. What is an Encore Career?
Right. So the book is the Encore Career Handbook. And an Encore Career is a second act that has some social purpose to it, that has some benefit for the greater good. So, you know, reinvention is all the rage right now. Everybody's reinventing. But this book is not the book that's going to tell you just about like how to open a vineyard or, you know, an artisanal bakery. Lots of people are looking to reinvent in the way that's going to help themselves and also help the world in some way. And that's what the Encore movement is about. It's about using these years, this new bonus period of life that we suddenly have, these years that have opened up, to do something that's going to have lasting impact, which is something people are really craving.
So not necessarily more of the same, not necessarily something completely different, but something, what, more altruistic, something more personally gratifying?
So interestingly, for many, many people, it's kind of something altruistic and maybe the first time they thought of work in that way. They may have had a corporate career and not really thought of wanting to do something in the kind of helping vein. But we're finding that it's true even for people who have been teachers their whole life, social workers, nonprofit people, that they too want to shake things up at this life stage. So they still may want to do something that's going to help, but they want to do it in a whole new way. And that kind of reinvention is also challenging.
And is that different from previous generations?
It is, because there is a new stage, a new life stage that really has opened up. So we used to have a 30-year career, if you had a career, right? And then you just wound down and moved right to retirement, and then, you know, it ended, right?
Right.
So now, you hit your 50s or 60s, and it's possible you're going to work for another 15, 20 years, and you're healthier, and you've got all this energy, and often a lot of talent and experience. And what are you going to do with that time? Even if you want leisure, even if you want to do all those things on your bucket list, you want to travel, you want to play more golf, you may not want to do that 5 or 7 days a week. So you may want something on your own terms.
So and when this is on your own terms, are you talking about dabblers? Are you talking about careerists somewhere in between?
The spectrum. So this book covers everything from the person who wants to be a literacy tutor at a school 2 or 3 days a week or 2 or 3 afternoons a week to someone who wants to found a nonprofit or a socially organized mission-based business and work harder than they've ever worked before. I've seen all parts of the spectrum.
Now, when you get these people back into the job market or the nonprofit arena, can there be a problem with, here comes Mr. Know-it-all walking down the hall, the experienced person? I mean, talk about that particular dynamic.
Yeah. So the people who succeed best in their encores are people who have a really healthy mix between knowing how to use their experience in this new environment and having a good dose of humility and realizing that they don't know everything. And one of the things they may not know is how things get done in the new culture they're joining, or at this changing world of work where technology is used differently or the intergenerational interplay is different. So we find the people who succeed best of this at this are people who have a good balance of those two attributes.
And understand that a manager that they are dealing with is still the manager.
Yeah. So often you may be working for someone much younger,
mm-hmm.
And we see a lot of cross-mentoring going on. So a lot of, you know, young people who are so thrilled to be working with someone with years of experience, but that experienced person saying, wow, I can learn a lot from someone who's young enough to be my child.
So someone watching right now says, this is interesting. This is something I'd like to give it a try. What are the steps? What do they do?
Well, if you live here in Arizona, in Phoenix, you are lucky enough to have a great organization, Experience Matters, right here, that is here to help you launch your Encore. So you can get involved in volunteering, you can consider an Encore Fellowship, which is a sector switcher program where people from the nonprofit sector get matched with nonprofits in very, you know, high impact work. You could buy this book and do all the exercises and really do some introspection and really kind of figure out what is it that you want right now, because it may not even be in your head. You may know what you want and need to figure out how to get there, but you may not even know what you want right now, and that's pretty common also.
You've had quite a career yourself in journalism, and now you are doing this. It sounds like an Encore career for you. Am I mistaken there?
You know, yes and no. I call it, I had my early Encore moment, because I've had a few career changes already. I'm a little younger than a lot of the people that I was writing about, but I certainly know how to stay in the game and reinvent continuously from what I've learned from talking to all these people who are just a step ahead of me in the career process.
But you got involved this for what reason? People see journalists and then they see this, and that's a bit of a shift. Why so much focus?
Yeah, so what happened for me is my first career change happened in my 30s. I was a corporate lawyer, and I had a kind of crisis of conscience after about 9 or 10 years. I woke up one day and just said, I just can't do this anymore. I can't do work that I don't believe in. I want to do something that feels truer to my values. And I became a journalist. And it was a very, very hard transition. It took me years. And eventually I started writing very regularly for the New York Times, where I ultimately had my own column and blog called Shifting Careers. And it's through that work that I became aware of the Encore movement. I interviewed the founder of a nonprofit called Encore.org. It used to be called Civic Ventures. And Mark Friedman, who wrote the foreword to this book, I profiled him for the New York Times. And I wrote about all this incredible stuff that baby boomers were doing. Encore.org runs something called the Purpose Prize, and you have your own Purpose Prize right here in Phoenix right now. It's huge cash awards, $100,000 prizes for social innovators over the age of 60. And the idea behind this work is that we all need to change our perception of what it means to be this age. It used to be that this is the time you're winding down and you're kind of, you know, passing on the reins and getting out of the way. But really, people at this new Encore stage are doing really valuable work, and they have all this energy that they want to apply, and there is a huge talent force that can be applied to solving all these social problems.
With that in mind, is there one question you hear the most from second careerists or those interested in going this direction?
Yeah, one question I hear the most is, who's going to want me? Who's going to hire me? What about age discrimination? And I hear that quite a lot. And the people who do best are the people who don't fixate on that question. You're going to have to go to places that value experience. So that's why groups like Experience Matters are so important, because they are working to educate nonprofits and social change organizations how best to use the talent of baby boomers. So you're probably going to do best in places who already have a consciousness of wanting to have an intergenerational workforce and wanting to value your contributions.
All right. Very good. Good to have you here. Good luck on the book tour. Thanks for joining us. We appreciate it.
Thank you.